feel. Radio Yesterova. Radio Yesterova.
Welcome to the leading internet radio station in the Mother City. There are many ways to stream our shows. Visit us on our Facebook page, live at Radio East River. Also, visit us on our website, www.radioeastriver.co.za, or download the Radio East River app, available and supported on any and all smart devices. Radio East River, die ding ruk hier.
My man on the road, he doing promo. Used to keep our business on the low low. I'm just trying to get you out the friend zone, cause you look even better than the photos. I can't find your house, send me the info. Driving through the gated residential, found out I was coming, sent your friends home. Keep on trying to hide it, but your friends know. You know we keep it simple. Trying to keep it up don't seem so simple. I just, before I saw you, and you gon' have to do it at my tempo. Always try to send me off to rehab. Started feeling like it's decaf. I'm just trying to live life for the moment. And all these motherfuckers
o'clock.
She's savage like that.
What?
No, don't worry.
Nothing. Go on.
This joke is not for the radio.
Yeah, go on.
We'll tell you later.
Skinnering there about about
just
something.
Just go on. Introduce us.
Okay, and we are live. It's 1 o'clock. It's Tuesday.
Means like you're not skinnering about you.
Yeah.
Yesterday.
Yeah, I wanted to know the joke. You guys are like laughing here.
So
we'll tell you later.
We'll tell you later. Why do you have to be part of it? Like, you don't have to be.
It's like it's supposed to be an inside joke now.
I mean, really now.
That's funny.
Now it's how many listeners does a radio station have? Like.
Someone who knows.
Like 100,000
you know?
People now. And now we must know. Share. Like, hey, now you feel that pressure to, like, oh, damn, now we have to share what we.
No, we don't have to share anything.
Okay, so it's 1 o'clock. It's Tuesday. This is the movies with your hosts, Jenna, Olivia, and Shadow.
Yeah. Ooh, ho, ha, 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 ha.
Okay, so we don't have any lists for you guys today.
No list today.
No book for
also,
you guys.
Also because we couldn't think of a list to do.
I think we did everything.
We had a ton of lists already.
I didn't think we did everything.
We could
though.
Never go through everything. Okay,
no,
cool.
There's like,
next week, I'll come up with two lists. Yeah, obviously, yep. You guys know what my categories are. Boom!
But we do have.
I'll have some Western in there.
We can give some reviews of the ones that we did watch.
Some movies we watched.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so far, my favorite are
the new releases.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we watched.
Hitman.
Oh yeah, I saw that one.
From Glenn Powell.
Is it
Powell?
How funny is it?
It's not funny. It's just funny.
There's no jokes.
There's no jokes, but
it
has its moments, right? And then
is he like a Kevin Hart where he needs to sort of make actions like funny?
Okay, the character himself isn't a funny type of person.
Oh, okay.
He doesn't try to be funny, so he isn't funny. He's just a person that is socially awkward.
Okay, cool.
He makes a personality that everybody else wants.
Yeah, so he's not funny.
Yeah.
It's not supposed to be a comedy like that. For me, it wasn't like that. It was more like a weird type of romance type of thing going on.
Oh, there's romance too?
One of the people. And then we're also doing Boy Kills World.
Okay, I saw that one as well. I was not too impressed.
It needed something.
It wasn't bad.
They tried to do more kung fu.
Did more fighting scenes.
And also, like, I feel like, was he too, staring, man? Like the main guy in the movie.
Yeah, they showed.
Like him. I feel like he was protected by that. Like he would get into fight with like 10 people, but like he won't die.
And he didn't get a score. Oh. He didn't get shot.
He doesn't get shot.
He did get that cut on his leg,
though.
Once. Please, come on. Taking on like 20 guys, and he can't. He's not like some. What are these action heroes who could like. He can hit everybody and, Jet Li type of. Or Jackie Chan type of.
The guy's name is also. He never gets hit.
So he gets hit, Steven Seagal. Mm. Yes. So he gets hit, but
Chuck
like
Norris.
He doesn't die and stuff.
Yeah, but Chuck Norris has like a his belt now. What is that? The super guy. And then we're doing the Fall Guy.
Okay, Ryan Gosling. Not bad. Not bad, but
it had its moments.
Could have done a bit more.
Could be better. And then we watched the first episode
of House of the Dragon.
Obviously.
It was let down.
It was let down. Me.
Oh, okay.
I mean, as a person that reads,
it
was a let down.
Who's read the book?
Yeah, we know what's happening in that book, and it was a disaster. For me, anyway, but they are worse fans than us.
Did I take this thing off?
when did you take it off?
I don't remember.
Okay, so what are you going to start with?
House of the Dragon?
No, we had a conversation since last night of the disappointment we had.
Like, you guys are the only people who watch House of Dragon. Oh my gosh.
You know what? We're going to start with Hitman because it was awesome.
Also, because I only finished it yesterday.
Okay, so Hitman is about the movie. This guy, he is a professor at the university.
Is he a psychology type of professor?
I think so, yeah. But what is he? Is he in college or high school?
College of New Orleans.
Yeah, so he's a professor at a college.
But he also
part-times at the police station.
As a tech.
Undercover.
Those
wire stuff he used to do. Then one day, the guy that does that plays as
the undercover
hitman, the fake hitman now, he was suspended
for
a video of him
attacking two teenagers. two teenagers and of color.
Okay.
So they suspended him for
120 something days.
Mm-hmm. Are you sure? Then you got, so now they needed now a new guy to be their hitman for the sting operations. So they just used him.
Mm.
Right? So what he does is he studies the person. They'd be like, Jenna came out looking for the hitman. Now he studies Jenna's profile.
Okay.
Right? So he finds out that Jenna prefers a hitman that, like, from The Godfather. So now he dresses up and he gives off that energy of. So then Jenna will incriminate herself and then boom, she's arrested. So he does that for a while until he starts playing a guy named Ron.
No, Ron is him. It was always Ron.
Is he?
No, he wasn't always Ron.
Yes.
Is he is them?
When the first time he was there, his name's Ron. Forever. It's Ron.
He identifies with he, them, they.
Ron is the person. Ron is the hitman and Gary is him.
No, but he's only Ron with the hitman, with that girl.
No, he's Ron.
But it changes his clothes every time.
But he's Ron.
Okay, I guess it's because it's an easy name. But he's anyway, Ron. So then there was this one lady that came to him
named Madison. Madison, to kill
her husband.
Mm-hmm.
Right,
unalive husband.
Unalive.
Unalive her husband.
It's like the
but
word.
You could see, and I think you saw it too, that she.
She was scared.
She was afraid of her husband. You could see that she was being
abused
like, and things like that. So he tries to talk her out of it. Is this really what you want?
Mm.
You know, you can just leave him. Because she gives him the money, then he was like, take the money and just start new. Don't go home again. File for divorce. And that's what she did. And that's the first time the operation that he went to failed to get the suspect. Then he starts dating her, but not as himself, but as Ron. So now she's thinking she's dating this hitman guy. Can't he's this is a teacher here at the school.
But she doesn't know he's a hitman. Oh yes, she
knows he's a hitman
because like he's called for
right. Because she then he gives her these rules. They can't go to his house. They can't be a lot in public together. Yeah. So they're always like at her house. And then they went to the club, right? They
got
to
this Virgo,
right? And it turns out her husband was there
at the club.
At the club, so he pulls out the gun, acting as Ron the hitman. Pulls out the gun, all that things. Then I think they went to this ice cream place. Then that guy that was suspended notices
Jasper
notices him and approaches the table and it's like, oh hello, and he's like, you look familiar. You know that moment where you're like, you're trying to, like, you were catfishing this person the whole time, telling them you're the successful person, but the actual person that knows you comes to your table and be like, oh hello Jenna.
Yo, then they say your real name. Yo.
And I was like, oh, he's about to do that because Jasper is that type of person that would, you know. And then the twist happens when the husband, Madison's husband, is looking for a hitman. And it was now Gareth or Ron. And then turns out that Madison doesn't need a hitman anymore. At all, if you know
she
what I mean.
She killed her own husband.
Yes.
They weren't actually divorced.
Yeah.
And also...
Plot twist in Yana there.
A plot twist.
A big plot twist there. I didn't think it was right. But I was like, oh gosh, Madison's going to be devastated. She said she killed him herself. That was a big plot twist to me. I didn't see that coming. I didn't see that coming. At first, I thought it was Gareth who did it. I already thought it was Gareth who did it.
Who's Gareth?
What's his name then?
Gary.
Is his name not Gareth?
Ooh, it's Gareth.
Ron's real name.
His name is Gary.
Are you sure?
His name's Gary. I'm
calling him Gareth the whole time.
His name is Gary.
Whatever, Gareth sounds way better.
Yeah, it's the same.
Anyway, so he must stage now to incriminate Madison once again. But this time the police know that
Madison was at the bar.
Madison, not just that, but Madison was at a bar almost, right? And then they just know that someone pulled a gun out at this, what's his name?
Mike,
the husband. They just don't know who the boyfriend now was.
Mm.
And then he has to put a sting on her now to confess because the insurance, life insurance money was
increased by a million.
So the only person that could benefit would be
the wife.
The wife.
Oh, of course.
Would be the wife. So he didn't think it was her at first. So he goes there and he tells her, I killed him. I killed because you said he was going to kill me.
So I just killed him before he could kill me.
So she admitted the truth. But I thought that was going to be the end because she knows now that his name isn't Ron.
Mm.
And that he isn't a hitman. And that he's actually a professor at a school. But then they actually kill...
Jasper ends up dying. It's...
Actually, I have to say that he was murdered. Yeah. Jasper was murdered. By none other
than Ron. Gary.
Ron?
Gary killed him, not Ron.
Let's be honest, Gary couldn't do it. He had to channel his inner Ron. Like we're doing the whole time now. Like we're doing the whole time. And also, he's still friends with his ex-wife. Like best friends. You didn't notice that before? You did.
I did.
It was just me.
I did. Okay, but, so next movie.
Yeah, no, me, I'm not watching Hitman.
You're not watching Hitman?
Nah, so, it sounds boring.
He ends up becoming this totally different guy. He ends up becoming Ron.
He ends up becoming Ron.
Ron and not Gary.
The phone.
I can't read
it. Oh, okay. Hmm. Yeah, and anyway, what's next?
You, okay, so we'll go next.
Hitman, I'm gonna keep skipping it on my thing.
Up, we have Boy Kills World.
Oh yeah, World. Like the actor, think he's very cool. Well, all of those Scott,
yes, they are. I actually
brothers and father.
And father.
Father's genius. Yeah.
You don't find it weird that they look nothing like their dad? Like, they always look like so towering over there.
They look alike, but the father looks different.
It's almost like, who are you?
Like, he's blonde even. Like, yeah, they're not really...
They're not blonde because they have those dark... Probably features, from the mother.
I can't describe...
Yeah, they look alike, though. Mm. You what?
I can't describe Boy Kills World.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
There was a twist.
He's we'll start from the beginning.
It's like
so in the beginning, right?
In the beginning,
there is this. It's like not a country, but like they rule the city.
Oh yes,
right. And there's
to enforce the
family. And every year, called the Culling Day, they kill the enemies in front of everyone.
Mm.
Don't you feel they're just taking you from the...
Enemies as in people who are trying to sort of go against
overthrow them, maybe wrong them, maybe try to...
Propaganda.
And unfortunately, on this day, Scott's family, when he was still a boy, got picked. And his mother and sister died.
Auntie, the mom had like guns and stuff.
I was so confused at that point.
Tried to overthrow the government.
In the flashbacks, basically, it doesn't show him being killed.
Because his memory shows that he got stung, cut off, and that he
Did they cut his tongue off?
Yes.
And that's why he doesn't talk, he talks with his imaginary...
And then I don't know what they did with his ears.
They burned his ears.
So that he can't hear.
And then they choked him. And they hang him up the tree.
Okay.
And I think it's going to be called the hanging tree.
That's what he recalls from his memories.
And this other Chinese guy...
The shaman. Saved him.
I like the speaking...
The voice.
I love that part.
And for the past years, this shaman has been training him
so that he can avenge.
He didn't want to train him at first, right?
He didn't want him.
Yeah, I remember.
But then
started training.
The years
him.
Went by
because he ran up. Away most, and then like he ended up by this shaman guy,
yes,
right?
And then years went by, and he's now Scott.
Mm.
And then he went to the city because the shaman guy, he sells cabbages into this little village.
Okay.
And
oh, he's got a stochi there.
A stochi.
Right. He's just sitting there
at a stochi. And, right, and this fateful day where Bill Skarsgård's character, what's his name? They don't say his name. But when you see, if you read the credits, it's just his kid.
I don't know his name.
Okay, now Bill Skarsgård's character.
Okay.
This faithful day.
Feels like a bully.
Yeah, so Billy goes into the city this faithful day and it ends up being called the culling day.
Oh, okay.
And now
there was another family.
Yes.
That also got picked and
he got those flashbacks.
He wanted to go and protect again.
Yes, but you know, the shaman guy pulled him back. Yeah, and he's like, bro, you can't do that.
It's not your fight, nigga.
You know?
Yeah, but I mean, it didn't matter because
of the day, he did go. He sneaked into the guy's boot throughout
there
the
day. There was a corpse.
He went to the city.
Is it just me, but that guy that does the speech. Mm. There's a bit of comedy there, but that guy, though, he was funny to me anyway.
Isn't he the South African guy?
He's the same guy that plays in Monkey Man.
Monkey Man, yes, man. I was like, no.
And it's
a similar character. Yes. What's his name? Shalto.
I don't know, but I was like, wait, aren't you from Monkey
it's,
Man?
It's the same.
Because it's the same guy, isn't it?
Yeah, even on Monkey Man, he's almost like someone who's like a dictator of sorts and... Yeah, no, like a presenter of...
like a host type of thing. Yeah, like,
and a bad guy too.
Yes, I was wait, isn't
the
this...
The same, Shalto.
Shalto. I was like, wait, is this you?
Nah, he's brilliant,
it's
brilliant.
It's gotta be you.
Okay, so... Then he goes into the city. And he fights...
There are some unrealistic things. Like, as you mentioned, how can he fight all those guys?
And then he ends up fighting.
Yeah,
like, how good of a fighter are you?
He is not even that good of a fighter.
Like,
how
good
like,
of a fighter?
But Basho, he was beating people.
Basho was funny, though.
It's like one of those where you've got a gun, but you want to come to the guy and, like, hit him with the gun. Just shoot from a distance. It was like one of those movies.
Where he did shoot. The weird part was the grater. The rasper.
I don't know.
Where's the restriction?
He starts fighting with the rasper. Yeah. He starts grating the people.
And then he's dodging bullets coming towards the guy. I was like, no. Unless he's got superpowers. That's
he doesn't have no superpowers.
Exactly. That's the part that annoyed me. Like, who dodges bullets? Like,
you can't dodge bullets.
He's Superman.
He didn't once get a cut.
Nah.
He only got the cut at the end.
Okay, so he starts fighting those millions and millions of
people. Bad guy.
And he ends up freeing this guy named Basho that says he's going to help this now bully get to the high people and get his revenge. So he ends up killing those millions of people you know, the impossibleness.
They start calling him the secret weapon.
Mm.
Oh, okay.
And his name is now, you know, Basho takes him to the secret hut.
Basho
ends up taking him to like the secret place called the Resistance.
Okay.
There's only one guy.
You know.
Okay.
Everyone was killed off. I can't really understand what the guy was saying. He was speaking some weird language.
Yeah. I don't know what the language is.
Bop, wop, things like that. Yeah. So.
Bop, wop, wop.
So Billy couldn't really read his lips that well.
Oh, okay.
So he didn't actually know the plan either.
Because
he was supposed to be the distraction. He didn't know that.
I can't watch that movie again.
I wouldn't watch it again.
I would watch it again.
It was interesting when the twist happened.
Yeah.
I didn't see the twist happening.
I'll probably finish it for the twist, but...
I don't know. Should we tell you the twist?
Don't tell me the twist, but
there is a twist in, right, that I didn't see coming.
There is a twist.
There is a huge twist that changed it. But the ending was very disappointing.
Yeah, you see?
Okay. I don't know. I expected more.
I also expected more.
But it was very disappointing. Ending was very disappointing to me. I mean, come on. All this trouble. All your Jackie Chan, Jet Li moves were used.
And nothing happens in the end. Okay, so, you know, he ends up... The culling day ends up happening. He ends up getting kidnapped, you know, getting caught.
He does get caught.
He does get caught.
This other chick... I don't want to spoil it. I can't spoil it. Okay. So it's other chick now that works for those family Muslims.
Ends up catching Bali.
They torture Bali. Bali
a bitchy there.
The people, then the one guy on the inside, the family member, betrays them. I can say that because it's not actually a big spoiler. But if you watch it, you would see that the
real villain is actually
the people, but it's not.
It's the shaman.
Why would you go and spoil it?
Listen, it's a movie. You just spoiled it.
Review show. Of course, I'm gonna have to review this.
No, you don't need to spoil. My word. Gee, was okay, you I'm just sorry said?
For the spoiler.
Okay. But at least he doesn't know how.
She's probably gonna say it now.
I won't. Okay.
You know.
So he ends up, he also sees
the ghost of his sister.
Yeah, he makes up the ghost of his sister.
Wait, the ghost keeps talking with him every time. She's always there.
She's always there, and somehow he's always there.
I'll finish it, but it's not something.
No,
I'll
don't finish it. Just continue I can where watch you left.
Just continue where you left
where
off.
You left off. And just watch it on.
I think keep where he's fighting 100 people but doesn't die.
It's also kind of weird that he fights people, he doesn't get hurt, he only gets hurt at the end.
You got that cut on his leg,
but one thing I saw about these new releases on like this movie is basically a Kill Bill.
Yeah.
Kill Bill, Revenge on the World type of movie.
Except for he
not original.
They're not original, man. I feel like they just get ideas from like the older movies, just like that one off Henry Cavill, where they fight the Nazis and stuff. I feel like they try to copy Inglourious Basterds too much.
Way too much. Okay, but you know he ends up killing everyone.
Everyone dies.
Except him.
Except for him.
And he finds out that someone that he loved, I'm not spoiling it, that he loves, is actually alive.
You're about to spoil it there.
But he does eventually stop seeing the
ghost of his sister ends up stops seeing.
Yeah. So I think he found because peace.
He found peace, or he dealt with some issues from his past.
Mm. But other than that, I can't say anything. I was going to spoil the movie, but other than that, the only weird thing was, I don't know why, but I was kind of waiting for Bill to at least say one word. Until I saw, he has
no. The bad guy isn't actually the bad guy, the good guy isn't actually the good guy.
Mm.
Yeah, but then again, think about it, the culling is kind of savage, don't you think?
I don't know, man. That's just sick ass.
It's some type of weird, Hunger Games thing. We just
it's pick like Hunger Games. So you pick up people and
you have to kill them.
Just unalive them.
Unalive them. Also.
Yeah, guys.
Okay,
so we're gonna go to a little. How much movie do we have left?
Two.
Okay, so we're gonna go to a little music break, and then we will be back with the next two movies.
Dodging death in the 6 feet. Amphetamine got my stomach feeling sickly. Yeah, I want it all now. I've been running through the need a dog pound. 100 models getting faded in a compound. Trying to love me, but they never get a pulse down. Cause I'm heartless, and I'm back to my ways. Cause I'm heartless. All this money. Oh, shorts now. Cause I'm heartless, and I'm back to my ways cause I'm heartless. All this money and this pain got me heartless. For life, cause I'm heartless. Said I'm heartless, trying to be a better man, but I'm heartless. Never feel what I can, but I'm heartless. No life, for life, cause I'm heartless.
And we are back. So we've come to the last two movies, which
Last one is actually a movie because you never watched it. Okay, so
basically the last one movie, and then we've got the series. You know, so what was the movie again?
Fall Guy.
Starring Ryan Gosling and what's her name?
Emily Blunt. It is Emily Blunt.
I don't know.
Yeah, Emily Blunt.
Mm-hmm. So Fall Guy. Is it your turn to describe?
It's played by Ryan Gosling. He's a stuntman.
The stuntman.
I guess it's supposed to show that a movie doesn't just take an actor, but also the stuntman. Especially for those actors that don't do their own stunts.
Yeah.
Like, I know for a fact Jackie Chan does all his stunts.
He does. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
He even has a plate.
He has a plate in his a metal plate in his head. He got hurt, hit his head, and then they had to put the plate in his skull.
Tom Cruise also does his best to do most of his stunts as well.
One of those Mission Impossible movies, I think he broke his ankle.
Yeah.
And I think now the guy from Monkey Man broke his wrist.
Yes. He also tried his own stunts.
So I think they're very dangerous. Maybe we should just let the professionals do it. But I guess if you do your own stunts, you get paid more.
I think so.
If you what?
Do your own stunts, you get paid more.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I doubt they do it for that.
I think it's because...
Because they really get tons of money for an actor, when
a stuntman does the stunts, the tech people sort of has to go and see if they can put the face on and all that.
Yeah,
so,
which AI does right now, for instance.
Yeah.
But I think it's also for that street credibility. It's to give you that, you know, like...
I did actually do the somersault, guys.
Yeah, I can do
the somersault.
It gives you that kind of edge.
You know, I am an action hero because I did the action scene. But anyway, so Ryan Gosling's character is a stuntman for this actor who's called Tom Raider.
Drama queen.
Tom Raider. Oh, gosh. For Tom Raider, who is not supposed to be like the action-packed hero of
this movie, called
there's not just that movie. It's like he's a stuntman for every movie that Tom Raider does. It's almost like I'm an actress. I'm taking Jenna as my stuntman
for all my movies.
Yep.
Yeah.
So
he also becomes like his in personal life as well. He has to sort of sort out his problems and. Because real actors, he's got issues, major issues.
So, Ryan Gosling's character was doing a stunt, and he broke his back.
He had to fall.
That
falling cable, scenes, you know.
It didn't support, and he broke his back. And he was out of a job. We can't use a stuntman that's broken.
But he wasn't out of the job. They were actually waited for him to go and get fixed, but then he doesn't want to.
Yeah, he never went back.
He just never went back.
He even changed his number.
Everything. So he started parked in cars.
Became a valet.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
At least you got free burritos.
Every day.
It's okay.
Every
day.
That's what he says, actually. So, Tom Raiders, what? His assistant? His agent? What is the lady?
She's a producer for the movie.
No, but she's always with him.
Not an assistant.
But they're always together.
I think she's his manager or something.
Yeah, like I thought it was manager. Because they're always together. Mm. Anyway, phones for Tom. Not the director chick that he's in love with. Not the calls now for Ryan's character and tells him that they need him to be the stuntman because Tom's
he's gone. He's
gone. He's gone. It doesn't end. They can't find a
because he does that. He's like
enough replacement.
Those troublesome actors and stuff.
So he goes he does the stunt. But the director now. He was under the impression that she asked him by name. She never did. She didn't want him there at all.
Yeah, because he's injured and like...
And also because he ghosted her.
He ghosted her.
Yes, he did because like he was injured and the guy was like depressed and...
He changed
you know?
His number. Yeah. That is what got her because she wanted to be there for him.
But then he just pushed her away like... Go back.
Yeah, so...
let me recover.
Yeah,
like,
so...
You know?
Turns out that... That's not even the plot. I thought it was the plot. You know, him coming back as a stuntman.
That's not the plot.
So
turns out, Tom Raider is missing in action.
Is missing.
He's gone.
The actor is missing.
Okay.
Arthur Johnson's character is gone.
Yeah, he's missing. And they don't know
where he is.
But the only thing she says is that he was busy with some dodgy things.
Yes, I remember that.
With some drugs and some
alcohol and partying. Okay, so he goes to the apartment thing.
But also needs a secret code.
Yeah.
Secret code for what?
To get into the password. Like, you need someone.
You need a code.
Fruit salad. A fruit salad. You have to go to the reception and like,
no, not that salad. Not yet there. No, and where he goes to the apartment where he meets the girl, the girlfriend.
Yes,
the girlfriend. That fights him with the katana.
Which is actually
a prop.
Yeah.
Oh.
A fake katana.
But he didn't think that it was a fake
katana. That girl in his flat, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
I also didn't think it was a fake.
It looked so real.
Exactly. And then she was like, I'm just a wonderful actress. Because he was like, because when he had the katana, he was like, is this a prop?
He pulled the sword and he was like,
it's a prop. Yeah. So anyway, I think then she was like, yeah, with the pop, it was...
It's not a bad movie.
It's not a bad movie.
Not a bad movie.
She said pavos.
Oh, she said pavo.
She said pavo.
Why is she like a pavo?
And then he's like, what is that?
What's a pavo?
It's a poor person.
It's a poor person.
Pavo.
And I don't know why, but when she said pavo, I saw the guy from TikTok.
Oh, no, of course.
You saw him.
Hello.
Shamsi. Yeah, he just saw him. Yeah, I don't know why, but I was like, Pavo. And I was like, oh,
lying in
you
bed.
Follow him too.
He's lying in bed there with his blanket.
And he's stomping.
Actually, one view is like, don't be born poor. Yeah. Be born for generational wealth. If you are born with generational wealth, everything in your house will be beige. You'll wear beige pants with a beige shirt, with beige shoes, with a beige coffee and a beige cup.
So I guess we've bought into generational wealth.
Also need to have nice ice cubies.
Yeah, I know it has to be.
Ice cubies with roses in. Like ice designed. Cubies with lemon.
Mm-hmm.
Round ice cubies, hot ice cubies. Yep. Everything.
Hang on with the movie.
So
I love him, you know, Shamsi. And his book is also successful.
He's iconic, Jenna. He's iconic. And I like how he finds the most weirdest of things. Like, I think I learned it from him where someone bought an invisible statue.
What?
An invisible statue. And then I googled it. I had to make sure about this nonsense that he was speaking. Yes, someone did buy an invisible statue. So if anyone wants to know, I have an invisible statue.
Just tells you like
this. Yes.
Just tells you, like, rich people will buy anything.
Just buy my invisible statue. You can't see it, but it's
I think that's what they do with art, actually. Art, like, they can... Because it's a way for them also to sort of evade tax by purchasing art, like, for ridiculous amounts of money, like...
But, you know, the art these days... I don't know if the artists are getting lazy, but they will just crunch a piece of toilet paper.
I'm telling you.
Put some glue on it. Boom! The winter sneezes. 18 grand is my starting amount, by the way.
Well, how about he'll make his vaslapi wet and then throw just it throw there. It. And then that's a piece of art, man. But anyway, moving away from the movie.
So he says, where does it go after that?
Goes to the club.
To the club.
Where and where Tom Brady was seen lost.
Right, and he gets drugged by the
drug dealer.
So he gets bumped by the car on purpose so the taxi can stop.
Okay.
Then he starts threatening the drug dealer, telling him where he is, and he's like, he doesn't know.
He was just hired to kill.
But he was just hired to was he supposed to kill?
Was supposed to kill him?
Yeah. Anyway, so he goes then to the hotel room. Which you have, there's like a little password you must give.
You must go to the reception, you must order.
You must salad. Look for Kyle. You must go
Kevin.
It's
Kevin.
Call him Kyle Mountain the whole time
Kyle.
Now.
Kyle.
His name is Kevin, Kyle. And you have to go and tell Kevin that you want a fruit salad.
Then the.
And Kevin will give you like a private key card so you can like swipe and go into this room where Tom Raider was seen last too.
So. He goes there, gets the key card doesn't work, so it's a whole little thing for the key card to finally work.
No.
He keeps walking up and down. Then he just breaks the door down.
Mm.
And then he finds a body.
On ice.
On ice. A dead body.
Okay.
Right? Dead man on ice.
A literal dead man on ice. Comes out of the room, tries to cover his face, you know, like from the cameras that is like in the passageway.
Mm.
And he phones Tom Raider's
assistant producer.
I don't know, his manager. Is it his manager?
I don't know. The lady that...
She's always there. So I think it was his manager. She's always there. But phones her to tell her that she was just inside this hotel room and there was a dead man in the bath. This is a crime. He's going to phone the police. And she's like, don't phone the police.
Don't phone the popo.
Anyway, so he's in the car and the police come to him because he's just like standing in the middle of the road. So the police comes to him and he's high. So he touches the police officer
just
to see
if the police officer is real.
And he tells them that he saw a body. They go to, and there's no body.
Are you gonna watch this movie again?
No.
Yeah, no, me too.
No. But the twist actually was that the manager that phoned him.
Okay.
Is also working with Tom Raider.
Tom Raider is a murderer. He murdered
his son. That's why they were looking for.
They murdered him.
Yeah.
Okay.
But the only cool thing was was the stunt that he did with
himself. The boat.
And the dog. The dog that if you give it a command, it just goes right for the crown jewels.
Yes, the dog.
The dog.
It's in Spanish, so French or something like that.
Goes right for the crown jewels. And the fact that at the end of the film, they actually used Jason
Momoa.
Mm.
Jason Momoa.
But he's, yeah. Of course.
They used Jason Momoa.
But like,
they CGI'd him.
Oh, so he like makes
they
a cameo.
CGI'd him.
No, if you watch afterwards, you will hear that the girl that walked the dogs.
Momoa.
She phoned and said, can you put me through to Jason Momoa's agent?
No, but they CGI'd him in. The whole movie was finished.
Oh, okay.
So they CGI'd him in.
No, they just like put the his little face
his
there.
Face,
but
CGI'd him in.
It was kind of weird. It was kind of weird, though.
It was kind of weird.
Nah, it's not a movie I'm going to watch again, but like, yeah.
It had its moments of comedy for me.
I can't wait to watch Bad Boys.
I'm disappointed that I can't watch
Furiosa.
Also disappointed that I can't watch it. All the good ones I can't watch.
Yeah, they're not out yet on our availabilities.
Our websites.
She always has to put us like that, girl. But
our Netflix box.
Also, I can't watch it in the cinema, guys. The prices there are just so high. I will just wait to stream it.
It's expensive, guys.
So if anyone has a Netflix account, is it on Netflix? Where is it?
Cinema.
People have watched it.
Cinema.
Okay, if anyone has an extra cinema.
Because other people was watching like poor quality. Like,
I don't want to watch poor quality.
Somebody standing up there in the cinema and then.
You can see the shadow
and then
the sound. You can hear the
people
background
are chatting there.
No, I want to watch
and the that movie. Picture quality, the sound.
Yo, and don't forget the little ad breaks in between.
Oh, no ways. Like
those little slots.
My
slots.
Word.
Oh, I hate them.
The shorts.
Okay, so.
But I just wanted to know, anyone that has watched the movie...
And you can, you know, get me a ticket in there. Or if you work at the cinema.
I just want to know, like, was the movie good?
Was it bad?
Because I've lots bad of people were talking about this movie bad a boys. Lot. Yes.
It was marketed very well, so...
How can I say, they weren't marketing it as much as these new movies are being marketed. Like, think of... Garfield was everywhere. Cumberbatch was everywhere.
They were everywhere. They were doing it organically. That's a nice thing. Like
they were just going.
The same when Kanye West, when he was releasing some limited edition of his clothing.
Yeah.
And then he paid like $7 million for the Super Bowl ad, but he recorded himself in his car,
so
talking about the clothes.
Like,
so Will Smith and Martin Lawrence were touring the world.
Yeah, but how can I say you didn't find a ton of different posters of
not posters.
Like, it's almost,
he was on TikTok and
it's almost like you know Bad Boys.
Social media
player. Is a new one, do you want it, don't want it? And the fans
It was a social media play.
They were there, except for me. I wasn't there.
Social media play, man.
Because the things are very expensive.
Tickets are very expensive.
I actually
like $500 for
congratulate
you and your
people that can afford to go to the cinemas because wow. What are you doing?
I'm clapping for them.
Because
they have the time and the energy to get to the home beds and go to the
cinema.
Because
I mean, it's like what, $150 or something a ticket, right? And then now think if you're going with your partner, $150, so that's like $300, and then like.
Popcorn
and a cool drink. You're not gonna share a cool drink, you're not gonna share the popcorn.
But
I
think.
And you still want like a chocolate nyana there. You
know, the only thing I also don't like about the cinema is that if I have to go to the toilet, I'm missing out on the movie.
I'm
not gonna pause the movie for me.
Everyone else is watching.
Guys, I'm very sorry about this, but can you just pause?
Or if you sleep there in the cinema, then you
it's not your fault. At least when you watch it at home, we stream it at home. I can pause it quickly, make me some coffee, but now
I'm
comfort.
But now I gotta just
and you can cook for your person, you know?
Cheaper.
Popcorn.
But now the only bad thing about streaming it is you have to wait. You have to wait.
Of course.
You have to wait, especially if you want good quality movie. Not having ads in between, or a character's face being blurred,
or the person is talking but there's no sound because you have to wait.
The words come later, like it's delayed.
Yeah, I hate those.
Or if it's good quality, then it's in
Spanish.
In Spanish,
yeah,
or
Oppenheimer happened to me like that, guys. I watched it, and I was like, Spanish, guys. At first, I thought maybe this is the beginning of the movie, and
hola,
it's gonna change.
Está?
Like, yeah, sure. And it's gonna change. It didn't. I went back to the middle of the movie, and it was still speaking Spanish. And I was like, I wonder if you can speak Spanish.
Oh, hola.
And then I was like, wait, but this is not your voice. And I was like. Know what? Delete.
Like, hey, hola, como está?
Then we watched House of the Dragon.
I would not.
Don't watch it.
Don't watch it. Your favorite.
It's my favorite. I'm not gonna lie.
Your favorite.
I was looking forward to this new season.
Me too.
Okay, I'm looking
forward
to it.
You know, the world was choosing their sides. New York, Team Green. Certainly, Team Green.
Paris,
Team Green.
New York's
Team Green. What was the other place? Belgium Team Red.
HBO was Team
HBO
Red.
HBO themselves Team
was
Red.
Was it Team Red? Is it not
Green,
Team Black?
Team Black, but their banner was red.
Yeah, and what was the other? The Bridge Team Black.
The only
people's place is Team Red. Team Black. Everyone was hyping up for this, but then boom, they hit you with the it's not gonna go. It's not gonna go in the books.
It does go in the book. But there's just
so
many
changes
to it.
Okay.
And it you know how, especially if you're releasing something per week, the episode should always leave you on a cliffhanger. To me, Jenna cried. I didn't cry.
I didn't cry.
She was crying. I'm not lying.
I was crying.
She was crying.
I was crying.
She was crying. Like, full on crying.
Ah.
So... No. Don't
for a film.
Now you're just being exaggerated. You there was a crime there. I was mumping around. And I was like, what?
And then I was like,
I know what was going to happen. And I was like, that was a disappointment though. And I was like, where is the other child?
I was disappointed because number one, there is characters missing.
So many.
But you guys are like gonna judge it according to the book. Like, not a lot of people read the books.
If we're not gonna go in the book,
something's
just didn't make sense.
Something just didn't make sense in there. And even if you didn't read the books, now if you watched the TikToks that the people have made over the people that have read it, and all those different errors that were made, you would realize that they made
both sides bad.
They made both sides bad. You can't choose a side.
Rhaenyra is bad because she's not being a queen. She's just more. She's being a mother and mourning her son. Okay. To a whole week outside, whole week not being queen.
Also, no offense to the people that made this, that produced this. Okay. But I don't know about you, but hair can't grow that fast. Children can't grow up that fast.
Oh, okay, okay.
At the episode nine, people's
characters themselves cannot change that fast. Mm-mm-mm. It just didn't make sense. Number one, the child. In the last episode, which is supposed to be a week before,
okay,
my hair can't be yabba my chin, and I come back and my hair can make a freaking long ass ponytail.
Wait, but like, so that week, are they not telling the story according to years after or months after?
No, it ended. If you watched it, it ended where Lucerys dies and Rhaenyra gets the raven that tells her that her son is dead.
Yeah,
right. Then the new season, episode one, is a week later. Right, a week later, Rhaenyra is being a
grieving mother and not the queen that she's supposed to be.
I don't care about the grieving mother. She is being boring. She's being boring.
You're so boring.
She's being boring. The dowager queen is raping men.
In the books, right? Damon was the one to say blood and cheese. Blood and cheese, rat catcher. Blood and cheese?
That is a gold cloak and a red catcher.
Rhaenyra comes back from her week-long hunt looking for her son's body.
Question number one. Just think of this. You don't have to even think of House of the Dragon, but think of this. I'm wearing my clothes.
And I get eaten by a shark
or something. Is my clothes still in perfect condition?
Hey, boo.
It's folded neatly.
And was in a net with a wing.
Is it almost like the Starbucks episode of Game of Thrones where the Starbucks cup was in the...
The whole episode was disappointing. There's only two true things in the whole episode is where Eric was like, the Kingsguard was sworn to protect the royal family, not to protect Rhaenyra or to protect Aegon. I side with that.
And where it was...
What am I supposed to do if I swore to protect Shadow and Jenna, but then Jenna and Shadow is fighting, who am I supposed to go to?
I must protect both of them.
I must protect where I can.
And
the second is the only true thing that happened.
Jane Arryn was like, she'll give her for a dragon to protect
that him. Is it. Then they recasted a character out of the blue. No one saw this happening. And then
got recasted.
Craigan Stark is being...
Isn't Craigan Stark disappoint- Lord of the North?
He's nope. disappointing.
He is.
He's very disappointing.
One of the Night Watchers.
I'm all for the Starks. I mean, they're the most
honorable
house that I've ever seen.
Yeah, of course.
You know, they're family above all else. In the book, the actual book, Fire and Blood, the Starks send their whole army.
But now,
to Rhaenyra, but he's sending them 3,000 old men.
Grayscales. They want old men. They're taking old men. Gray something. But it's old men. And they said that they want to be a part of the war. Okay.
Oh, they come there for peace, Madiba.
Okay. But anyway, it was a disaster.
Disappointing.
Very disappointing.
Disappointing. The one queen is moping around like a child. The other queen is raping men.
She's not a queen. Which one is? Queen.
The dowager queen is raping men.
And the queen is being a queen.
Damon is trying to be king.
Because Rhaenyra can't be queen.
Damon is waiting for war to happen. Corlys is going looking for his bastard son.
Is his
son.
Head still so awkwardly shaped?
Yes, it is. And the wig is not helping him anymore.
Oh, man.
The only actual person that's actually trying to help is Aegon.
Aegon is being king of the people.
He's trying to help the people. Other than that,
people.
No. disappointing. Disappointing first episode, and I'm thinking this whole season will be disappointing. That is why they're making a season 3 to make up for the disaster called season 2.
Sure.
You know what? Season episode
drop
2,
the mic, baby.
Episode 2 should be should fill up the gaps that they made in episode 1. Episode 1. Episode 1.
See, episode 2?
Oh, you're speaking WAP now.
Speaking like the guy from
Okay, guys, that was the show. Hope you enjoyed it, because I know I did. And I know Olivia did. And I know Shadow did.
No, I'm still disappointed.
No.
Disappointed in lots of things these days.
Okay, so we'll catch you next week. This is the movies. 1 o'clock. Bye-bye.
Radio is the river. Ons stasie, ons talent en ons mense.